Hey guys, it's Sarah. Yeah, I should totally be outside right now because it's such a nice day. It's warm out. It's like, what, September 2nd? Yeah, but you don't know. I'm inside because my brother is outside. My other brother's outside. So that's, I'm inside. And my parents aren't even home. So this is perfect. I can speak as loud as I want. Anyway, the Philly concert was last night. Not a lot went down. Just like a few things I wanted to touch upon. But first, before I get to any of that, here is Harry saying the Lord's name in vain. And oh my God, eargasm. The funniest part is that I love how everyone claps after, like, woo, yay, applause. But I think Harry got hit with something and that's why he said it. I don't know. He's like, Jesus Christ. I don't know. It just sounded really good to my ears. It's funny because if I said that at my house, I'd get a slap across my face. I mean, my family's not even religious, but for some reason, if I say Jesus Christ, it's like something bad. Like, what the fuck? We're not even religious. Whatever. Okay, but aside from that irrelevant shit, okay. I know I talk about the Rainbow Bondage Bears in like every video now. I talk about it all the time and you guys are probably like, oh my God, shut up. But no, oh my gosh, Harry is going to come out anytime now. I'm not even joking. Harry is going to come out. I know the break is March 2016 next year, but he will either come out before that, which might be unlikely, or he might come out like the last concert, which is October 31st, or maybe during the break. Simon Cowell even said after March 2016, he does not run the boys anymore. That means after March 2016, One Direction have a new record label. They're run by a new label after March 2016. So if I see new behavior between Larry after the break, March 2016, that means it was their management the entire time who was holding them back. I mean, just like the fact that Simon said he has nothing to do with the boys' careers after March 2016, that just made me rise. I can't wait until the boys go on break, and I can't wait till they come back, because we're going to see new boys. They're going to be run by a different label. I think they're going to be more free. It's going to be awesome. But anyway, here are the Rainbow Bondage Bears from last night, and the Rainbow Bondage Bear is reading an LGBTQ icon, Bette Davis's biography tonight in Outoree, Philadelphia. Actress Bette Davis, campy gender-bending style and acting has made her an LGBTQ icon, especially her performance in Dark Victory. It says something like she had a camp-worthy dialogue reflexive of a flamboyant gay queen of the dramatic arts. We all know that these Rainbow Bondage Bears are sending messages to us of how Louis and Harry are feeling and whatever. Everything that they do with these bears, it's so intentional. Why did they pick that book? They picked a book that was centered around an LGBTQ icon. Why would they pick any book? Like, seriously, they're just trying to tell the fans that there's going to be an outing, something. And it was the Harry Bear that was reading that because it had the green sticker on it. And not only that, on the book, it said HCPL. And HCPL, Holmes Chapel Public Library. Harry is from Holmes Chapel. Don't know if that has anything to do with it, but oh my God. And not only that, we have a third Rainbow Bondage Bear now. It's not rainbow, but it's just another bondage bear. A fan threw it on stage last concert, and it was like in like a Batman costume. So what they did is they took the Batman costume off, and then they put a Care Bear book next to this bondage bear. So now we have three bondage bears. Now there's an orange sticker present, and people say the orange sticker represents either Larry's Stylinson or Xander. I don't really care. All I know is that there's now three Rainbow Bondage Bears. I had a Care Bear book next to it. And there was a whole analysis with the Care Bear book too. Like, we all know Care Bears, they're about rainbows and happiness and like something like that. So I'm pretty sure, just like everything else in this fandom, there's probably a symbolic meaning with the Care Bear book too. I mean, I just think the boys are trying to tell us that we have to have faith. And I heard during some of the songs, Louis was fawning at Harry. Harry was fawning at Louis during the song 18. You know, typical stuff. We probably get that every concert. We all know Louis has been clubbing and stuff like that. But the only good thing that came out of Louis clubbing the other night is his glasses. Louis was wearing glasses while clubbing. We haven't seen him wear glasses since like 2010, and these actually look like the same glasses. That was the only thing I liked about those clubbing pictures, his glasses. Then the only other thing I heard that happened at the concert was that Louis and Harry went off stage by themselves. I don't know for how long, but I heard Liam and Niall were the only ones on stage after the song Fireproof, and then Louis and Harry just magically like walked off stage. If it was 5 minutes, you know, they probably been doing something, you know what I'm saying? But if it was just for like 30 seconds, they're probably getting like a drink of water, like changing or something. I mean, they share the same dressing room, so I don't know what's happening in there. I just love when Harry and Louis go off stage together by themselves and Liam and Niall stay on stage. I don't know if that's a choreographed thing. I don't know if someone told them to do that. It's happened before. This isn't the first time it's happened. Like, Louis and Harry have gone off stage just themselves before for a periodically amount of time. But I hope that they continue to go off stage with each other more often, you know? I love dying. All right, so if you know anything else Larry related or anything cool that happened at the Philly concert, leave it down below if I missed it. And like always, like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.